Today we'll continue with some few numericals. In that, in a phase shift oscillator, RC is equal to 2.2 kilo ohm, R is equal to 12 kilo ohm, C is equal to 0.22 microfarad. Determine the frequency of oscillation as certain, whether the oscillations will start or not. If transistor has HFE is equal to 200. So HFE is nothing but the beta value of the given transistor. In this kind of problem, you need to check whether the transistor is capable of producing the oscillation or not. So to this, in the last class, we have discussed about a equation, HFE equation. So if this given conditions are going to satisfy that conditions, the given parameters are going to satisfy that condition, then the we are going to tell it is going to produce oscillation. Otherwise, we tell that it is not going to produce oscillation. Also, along with that, in this problem, we need to find the frequency. So to do that, first we list out whatever is given. RC is given, it is 2.2 kilo ohm. R is given, it is 12 kilo ohm. And C is given, it is 0.22 microfarad. So as I told you, if you are given with RC value, you need to consider the K, the constant for the phase shift oscillator, that you need to consider, where K is given by RC by R. Whenever RC is given, then the formula will the formula which you are going to use is 1 divided by 2 pi into root. Sorry. One divided by 2 pi RC into root 6 plus 4k. Otherwise, this will be ignored. You will be having 1 divided by 2 pi RC root 6. Majority of the cases, K value will be ignored. But in this kind of problems where the oscillation, whether they'll be asking whether the oscillations is going to start or not, in that kind of problems, K value will be usually considered, where RC value will be given. So now find out K value, substitute in this, whatever the values they have given, R value is given, C value is given, and let me know what is the frequency produced. Let's do it.
First, find the k value, then go for f value.
Anybody got the f value or k value at least?
So k will be 0.183.
Yes, correct.
Yes, sir. 0.183.
Find the f value.
Sir, f is 0.027.
0.027.
Yes, sir.
Check it. You are telling in terms of kilohertz or what? Hertz?
Kilohertz, sir.
Kilohertz. Check it
once. 23.25 hertz.
Yes, it is 23.23 hertz. Okay, so this is the answer. After this, the standard condition to check whether oscillations will be produced or not is HFE greater than or equal to 4K plus 23 plus 29 by K. So this is the condition. Here they have given HFE is equal to 200. They have given this value. You need to substitute K value in this and you need to check what is the minimum requirement to start the oscillation and how much you are getting for this condition. They are telling HFE is 200, so they have given this value, and from this we need to find what is the value which is required.
Sir, you get 182.202.
Is correct. So we'll be getting 182.2. So HFE value should be greater than 182.2 to get the oscillation. We are having a transistor which is having HFE value has 200. So beta factor is 200. So obviously the oscillation will start. So it is going to produce the oscillation because minimum requirement is 182.2. This much of requirement is there from the transistor. So this is the required minimum required beta value of a transistor to start oscillation for a given for this given design. But we are given with a transistor of 200 beta factor. So obviously the oscillations are going to produce. You have to just write a sentence. Since in the given problem, HFE is given as 200 and the minimum requirement is 182.2, hence oscillation will start. So you have to just write the conclusion. To that, the next problem, find the value of R and C for an output frequency of 1 kilohertz in RC phase shift oscillator. So this is one of the typical problem where many of the students will not attempt this kind of problem only because nothing is given in this, only frequency is given. Either R is not given or C is given, both the unknowns, because whenever we are having two unknowns, according to the formula we are having F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi RC root 6. So in order to produce, in order to get R value, at least you need to know C value. F value we already know. Or in order to know C value, you need to know R value. So but here we are having two unknowns. So this kind of problem, if they are going to ask, then you need to assume one of the values, either R value or C value, you need to assume. But you cannot assume R value because the resistance cannot be assumed randomly. Unless you are having some set of resistors, and among the set of resistors to find out the resistance value of other resistance value, there you can assume one of the resistance. But here when you are having resistance and capacitance, during that time you cannot assume resistance value, you can only assume capacitance value. I repeat it again, if you are having two or three resistors, during that time you can assume one of the resistance value. But when you are supposed to assume among resistance and capacitance, during that time resistance cannot be assumed. So you have to assume capacitance, because we mainly concentrate on the amount of opposition which is being offered. So that's why the resistance cannot be assumed. We need to assume the capacitance value. So we have to assume, let C is equal to 0.1 microfarad. So if this kind of problems comes, so assume C is equal to 0.1 microfarad. Remember this value. F is equal to 1 divided by 2 pi RC into root 6. As I told, RC value is not given, don't consider K value, ignore it. If you take that formula, no, again it will become complex. You cannot do the problem, you cannot solve the problem itself. So just ignore that 4K, because RC value, I'm talking about this RC, don't get confused with this RC. So this value is not given, so ignore K. Now you rearrange this. As F value is given, just substitute it and find R value. Yeah, let me know the answer.
answer
649.74. Okay, correct. 649 or 645 is fine. 645.74. Oh, so this is the answer. So here C has to be assumed and R value you are going to find. So no need of substituting this again and finding C value, because you'll get back the same value. So that's why just assume this can be asked for 4 marks or 6 marks. Next problem. A crystal has L is equal to 0.4 Henry, C is equal to 0.085 picofarad, and Cm is equal to 1 picofarad with R is equal to 5 kilo ohm. Find first one, series resonant frequency. Second one, parallel resonant frequency. Third one, by what percentage does the parallel resonant frequency exceeds the series resonant frequency? Find the Q factor of the crystal. So this is the given problem. There are 4 subdivisions. First, you need to find series resonance. Second, parallel resonance frequency. Third one, percentage difference. And finally, the Q factor, quality factor of the crystal. So for the series resonant frequency, we are having formula 1 divided by 2 pi into root LC. This is the formula we are having, 1 divided by 2 pi into root LC. So just substitute the inductor value, capacitor value, and find out the series resonant frequency. And Nikita, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me why I'm not considering Cm here? Only I'm considering C here.
Don't know, sir.
You should know, no? While coming to the class, you should study and come. Akanksha?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me why we are not considering Cm? And why we are considering only C here? If you have listened to the last class, we'll be telling this.
So for parallel resonance frequency, sir?
No, I'm asking for series resonance frequency. I have just considered a LC. Why I am not considering CM? Here, why CM is not considered? Only C is considered here. Don't know. Good answer. Kirtana?
Yes, sir. In series, we'll have XL equal to XC, but for parallel, the reactant will be equal to the mounting capacitance. So in series, we'll take only LC. Sir.
Yes, good. See, in series resonance, we know that the mounting capacitance doesn't have any effect over the RLC circuit. We take XL is equal to XC in the series resonance, but in the parallel resonance, we take that the series resonance of RLC will be equal to the reactance of the RLC will be equal to the reactance of the mounting capacitance. So during that time, we have to take CM. But here we just take the reactance of the inductor is equal to reactance of the capacitor of RLC part only. So it is not going to have any effect of CM over series resonance. So that's why we are not considering CM. But in parallel resonance, we consider CM. Yes. Just substitute and tell me the answer.
Yes, Alfred, tell me series resonance frequency
answer. Alfred is not there.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me yes. FS.
FS. I don't know, sir.
Can't you do calculation at least?
One second. It's 63.138 kilowatts, sir.
Huh? What is the inductor value you used here?
0.4.
What is the capacitor value you used here?
0.4.
Inductor value?
0.4.
For FP also and tell me. For series resonance, it is 863.13 kilohertz. First, tell me what is equivalent, C equivalent.
Picofarad.
Picofarad. What is the value of pico?
Pico is 10 into the power minus 12, sir.
You are thinking so much when you have done the problem. Do it yourself. Don't ask others and tell the answer. Alfred.
Yes.
I can just know who is doing and who is asking others and telling the answer, all those things. And for everyone, you have to do it individually. You can escape today, but finally you have to write exam individually. No, your friends will not come and write the exam for you. And this is not the place where you need to help your friends. If you are helping your friend, means you are spoiling your friend. And if your friend is helping in telling the answer, means he is spoiling you. That's it. If you are intelligent, you'll understand this. If you are a fool, you'll not understand this. That's it. So on substituting for C into Cm by C plus Cm, because here the RLC circuit is in parallel with the mounting capacitance. So here the total capacitance will be, the effective capacitance will be 0.0783 picofarad. And now in this, when we substitute inductor value and the capacitor value. Yes, Sukkath, can you tell me the answer for parallel resonance?
Yes, sir. One second, sir. Doing so.
Okay.
So you get 899.74 kilohertz. So.
Yeah, correct. 899.07 kilohertz. So this is the parallel resonant frequency. So once we are done with this, now we need to find out the percentage change or percentage how much it is exceeding. So whenever you need to find out the increase in percentage, it might be with respect to efficiency, it might be in general also. Suppose you want to find out by how much percentage something is better than the other one, then also you can use the percentage regulation formula. So for percentage regulation, if you remember, we used to use VNL minus VFL by VFL, V no load minus V full load by V full load into 100. The same formula we are going to write for the frequency. In similar kind of formula, there we were talking about the voltage. Here we are going to write about the right with respect to frequency. So the percentage increase. So percentage increase will be equal to. So among this, which is highest, that we need to first look in. So 899.07 kilohertz, and this is the highest value. And one thing to just cross verify your answer in the exam, the hint is given in the question itself. Even though you forget also, if you forget that parallel resonant frequency will be more and series resonant frequency will be less for this problem, they have given the hint here. By what percentage the parallel resonant frequency exceed the series resonant frequency? So they are telling, they are giving the hint here only. Usually the parallel resonant frequency will be more compared to the series resonant frequency, as you can see in the graph also. So FP should be greater than FS. If you forget the graphs which we have studied for the characteristics of quartz crystal also, here in the question, they have given by what percentage parallel resonant frequency exceeds series resonant frequency. That means FP value, you should get greater than FS value. Suppose if you are getting FP value lesser than FS value, then somewhere you have gone wrong. This is how you can just cross verify your answer while doing the problem. So percentage increase, FP minus FS by FS into 100. By using this formula, so you can just recap the percentage regulation which you have done in rectifiers and all. So the same formula, we are writing it in terms of frequency for parallel resonance and series resonance. Just substitute it here and you'll get the percentage increase. Anubhav, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me the answer for this?
One second, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, 4.16%.
Yes, correct. So this is a percentage increase. This is the amount of frequency that is more compared to the series resonance. After this, we need to find the quality factor. So for quality factor, we have the formula Q is equal to omega s L by R. So this formula you might have already come across in the lab experiments to find the quality factor and all in unlock circuit lab. So omega s is given by 2 pi fs and L by R. Just substitute it and find the quality factor.
Sir,
433.86. Is correct. 433.86. This is the quality factor which we are going to get for the given design. So this is about this problem. And the last problem of this chapter, FET based Hartley oscillator circuit uses coupled coils in the tank circuit, each with inductance of 0.1 millihenry and mutual inductance 0.025 millihenry. The circuit uses a fixed capacitor of 100 picofarad in series with variable capacitance of 100 picofarad. So we call it as they call it as mounting capacitance, as well as sometimes they call it as trimmer capacitance. By both the names that we will be calling. So in this sub question is calculate percentage change in frequency when direction of coupling between coils is reversed and trimmer capacitance is made to be zero Second one. Solve. Part one. When trimmer capacitance is varied from 0 to 100 pF, assume any one direction of coupling. Say the toughest means you can get like this. This is one of the such problem. So here we will first list out whatever is been given. As it is mentioned, it is a Hartley oscillator. Obviously, it will be having two inductors. L1, it is 0.1 millihenry. L2, it is 0.1 millihenry. And they have even given the mutual inductance 0.025 millihenry, and C is equal to 100 picofarad. So each with inductance of 0.1 millihenry. So they are not telling you L1, L2 like that individually. You have to understand each means both. Obviously, L1, L2 will be 0.1 millihenry. So from this, we need to find out the first. We need to, you know, to find the percentage change in frequency. Just now in the last problem, what we did, no? Similar kind of problem. In order to find the percentage change, first you need to find out. There we did the percentage change with respect to series and parallel resonant frequency, but here we need to do the percentage change with respect to Hartley oscillator only by considering the changes in the capacitor. So we have the formula for Hartley oscillator: 1/2π (√L=C). So this is the formula we are having. See why I told this will be also called as mounting capacitor, because when we talk with respect to the Hartley oscillator, even though we are going to consider the L value, the two inductors and one capacitor, in our theory part we have discussed about individual parts which are going to be connected, but in the practical or real time application we are going to get a device, small device, which is going to have both together, inductor, two inductor, one capacitor, and we need to just tune it. There'll be similar, just like pot you'll be getting, and we need to tune it. So there they'll be using steel covering, so there that will be acting like mounting capacitance. But in our lab, whatever we are going to do, that is there, in that case you'll be not having any mounting capacitance and all, that will not come into picture at all. So, but when you take the latest applications, you'll be getting like that. But according to our theory, what we have discussed, you don't have any mounting capacitance for the Hartley or Colpitts oscillator. It comes only in the quartz crystal, quartz oscillator. Okay. So that's here, the trimmer capacitor, it is the variable capacitor which we are going to add along, see in series. One more just for the, it is a variable, one is fixed and other one is the variable one. So L equivalent is given as L1 plus L2 plus 2M. This is the formula. So in all the problems, whatever we have solved, we used to neglect the mutual inductance because it was not given, but here it is given, so consider it. So it is 0.25 millihenry, and just substitute here. So you'll be getting the answer on around 1.0065 megahertz. This is the answer you'll be getting. Just check the answer. After this, see, whatever we have done here, L1 plus L2 plus 2M, usually, well, for the analysis, we consider only the one direction of coupling. So we are going to consider only one direction of coupling. That means it is going to, they are going to be connected in a single unidirectional, and they are going to be having the charging discharging in the same loop. That means in only one direction. So when inductors are going to charge to the peak value, then capacitors are going to discharge like that. But even we can consider the reverse coupling also, where so in one cycle we'll be having a clockwise direction of charging discharging process, in other cycle it will be having in opposite direction, anti-clockwise direction of charging and discharging. So that is known as the reverse direction coupling. Okay, so since this problem is quite long, that we can continue in the next class. So now, as of now, you just find out F value. And after that, the next part we need to find out for when the direction of the coupling is reversed. So when the direction of coupling is reversed, just L1, L2 will be same, but the mutual inductance will become minus 2M. It becomes negative. Instead of here it was plus 2M, here it becomes minus 2M. So that is the change we will be having. So now in the here, for both the sub questions, we need to find out for one direction and reverse direction, both the cases. And along with that, you need to consider in the next case, and if that is in the second part, we need to consider the trimming capacitance, and we need to find out, after that we need to find out the percentage change. So since time is not there, we'll continue this in the next class, and after that we can go for the next chapter.